My agent called me from New York. He goes, hey, Bill, I know you got your big actorial debut coming up. Have you thought about losing some weight? I said, it's tomorrow, butthole. He said, I know, but they got a new product out now, and you might consider it while you're wearing it on set. It's called Spanx for Men. And, okay, apparently three women know what I'm talking about. Fellas, if you don't know what Spanx for Men is, it first came out of Spanx for Women. And if you don't know what that product is, have you ever gone out with your wife or your girlfriend and her butt looks amazing through dinner? And then you get home and she goes in the bedroom by herself. And then you hear this noise, blah, 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 blah. That heifer had on Spanx. See, some women are laughing right now because you can't breathe. And so what they make for women is a girdle, right? And what they make for men is this tight white t-shirt that's supposed to push the belly back up in the chest where it's originally designed to be at, right? So I go over and look at a Dillard's right here in Northeast Mall. It's $56 for just one plain white t-shirt. Okay, this already goes against my principle of buying a plain white shirt. People, I've been wearing a plain white shirt underneath my button-down shirt since I was 2 years old in short-legged pants. For $56, I'd get 72 Fruit of the Loom. That's all I'm telling you. For $56, I'd get 72 Fruit of the Loom and the Fruit of the Loom guys behind me singing and dancing. I get it home, right, and I'm a little claustrophobic anyway, and I get it, and it's just stuck to my face. Okay, maybe you're not physics majors over here. This happens to be smaller than this. If I can't get her over the melon. But I finally get my big fat head through it like I just birthed myself. And I shove my two arms through it and it's just balled up like a weird man's sports bra. That you then get to unroll over your own fatty flesh. And I look in the mirror and it looked like I need to take a dump. Just, I thought, Lord, I can't wear this on national television. They're gonna call it to the network. Let him get off the show and take a poo. And then when you take it off, it's like you just open up a can of biscuits. Do not do that from a mirror. It made me cry, like, holy hell, I can't go on TV, I'm not pretty. I went to Walmart that day. I didn't go to Walmart that day to buy anything. I just went to Walmart that day just to build up my self-esteem. Walked around the whole day going, I ain't that fat, I ain't that fat. Four biscuits away from a scooter. And it's my own ball, y'all, because they eat for crap. I mean, even on that day. Like, I don't know if you're in a McDonald's on January the 17th, 2 years ago, but I was. No, y'all need to understand, McDonald's is my go-to food. McDonald's is my comfort food. Sometimes I walk into McDonald's and go, give me a Happy Meal. There goes that for a boy or a girl. I go, it's for me. I'm sad and I want to be happy. Don't give me them boy toys. I already got the collection. Give me that girl stuff this time. So I left Walmart and walked into McDonald's like I had lost the will to live. And I look at the lady behind the counter and just go, just give me a McSalad. She goes, you want some dressing? I go, hell no, it goes straight to my hips. But they got a picture of a McRib behind this lady's head, glowing like it is the Messiah calling me home. And I go, screw it, ain't gonna make a difference in a day anyway. Go ahead and toss in one of them McRibs. That lady goes, you know, you can get you a second one for 99 cents. Okay. Hell, give me four.